Welcome to Keep It Simple Screenprinter. Today we're going to make a 85 LPI design using a GoCoPro screen. In a world where most of us believe that time is money, we're going to see just how quickly that we can get on press with a high resolution image starting with a blank frame. We're using 200 mesh. Now this is the special mesh for GoCoPro. It has a siliconized polymer sheet welded to the fabric. Mesh is held in place with locking bars, locking struts here. And the frame draw bar for tension. We're using a small screwdriver with a Allen bit. And I'm looking to keep it relatively level across there for even tension. And we're using a small cordless screwdriver. You don't want to use anything with really high amperage because you do not want to over tighten the mesh. This will get us to the 20-25 Newton range without any problems. It'll start to bog down. As you can hear now, it says we're getting tight. And looking across to see here. Drum tight, and we can take our scissors and cut off the excess and such. And there, and we are ready to go into the printer. Okay, welcome back. Now we're ready to load the frame into the GoCoPro QS2536. Here. There's three guides that the frame goes along. We have got an adjustable guide here that holds the frame securely in place. We bring down our print head, thermal print head. And we're going to print this crazy detailed old man. And we will hit Control P. It will bring up our printer. And there, we're 23 by 21 frame size. And here, we can go into setup. We'll go into our preferences here. We'll look at our image. We'll see we are set up for 85 LPI. And there, tell it OK. And print. And print. Now once these lights start flashing here, it's starting to receive information. As you can see, the computer is a little slower than the printer. It'll take just a minute. On that, now we're receiving data. once it's received all the information, you know, there was no RIP software. It was a simple print driver. The RIP and everything is actually inside the print engine of the printer. So all we had was a simple print driver. I could print from Adobe Illustrator, Photoshop, Corel Draw, Microsoft Publisher, Microsoft Word. I can print from Internet Explorer pulling up. Needless to say, your resolution is going to vary depending on how high the image is. But the print driver is, or the engine is in here. So there is no complicated RIP software. Now, you notice the dots have changed to zeros and it's flashing zeros. That means it's printing and the print head now is moving. So it is now printing. By printing, what we're actually referring to, it is a thermal print head. That entire long silver rectangular box you see there, underneath that is the thermal print head. It's actually burning the image or melting the holes in that polyester film that's attached to our mesh. And that's giving us our photo stencil. So there's no coating, no drying, no developing, no reclaiming, no chemicals, no emulsion, no exposure, no dry vault. There are no inkjet film, no inkjet printer, no film positives. It is extremely fast and very, very high resolution. This is printing at 600 by 1200 DPI is what it's burning the image. And right now this is at 85 LPI on 200 mesh. Compared to conventional screen printing, 85 LPI would need to be on 305 or 330 mesh. We're doing it on 200. Okay, it's almost done. Okay, I'll come back. And beep, beep, beep. And now we've got four green solid lines telling us that everything is done. We lift up the lever to unlatch it, take our screen out, and our screen is ready to go on press. So hang out for just a minute. We're going to be on press and we'll show you how to print. Okay, now we're ready to go on press. You do not have to tape the screen because the mesh is plastic welded with the polymer sheet on there, so no ink can get through, but I want to tape it because I want to keep my screen as clean as possible on here, and this will greatly speed up reclaiming, because when I'm done, I can scoop out the ink, remove my tape, cut out the mesh, and go to printing my next job right away. As I said, I'm mainly concerned with just keeping my frame clean because no ink is going to go through the mesh. But the mesh is completely sealed with that polymer sheet. To it. So I'm just using 2-inch. And here. One last piece. And you notice I'm cutting on the outside of my screen. I prefer to cut up here versus to cut anywhere near my mesh because I'm almost ready to start making money, and there's nothing more frustrating than to have a screen ready to go on press, ready to print, and somebody accidentally cuts it in the process. Okay, so there we go. Our screen is taped up, ready to go on press. We will slide it in here. I will center my artwork onto the platen, lock it down, and pound it back. And there we go. This image is going to fill up the entire plat. This is a large image. We're going to have as much dramatic effect as possible. Okay. We're going to use our Advantage 710 Premium Black. And yeah, this is 85 LPI design through 200 mesh. I'm just stirring it because plastol ink is schizotropic. If you stir it, agitate it, it will get softer. We'll spread this along the back. Certainly go from edge to edge. And a little more. There we go. Okay, we'll print some more of these shirts after we're done filming for a shop shirt. Okay. So. There we go. Cross. And now we're going to print onto a next level white t-shirt. And you can see 85 LPI on 200 mesh. Able to get an insane amount of detail. But for me, the most impressive thing about this is that we went from an empty screen to on press, 85 LPI design in under 10 minutes. Time is money. Stop by our Atlanta showroom and check out the demonstration for yourself. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like or a share. And as always, thanks for watching.